Hello, and thank you for visiting Lisa's Lair. And this is an old story from 2014, but for those of you who are new to Second Life in the last few years, you've joined the virtual space of Second Life, you may not have known about this story. But several years ago, there was a billionaire who was outed as a resident of Second Life. And the reason why I'm pointing out this article is because new people come into Second Life, and sometimes there's a perception that, oh, Second Life has a bunch of people who don't really have a life away from the keyboard, and Second Life becomes their central way of living and finding joy in their lives because they're not doing anything away from the keyboard. And there's that misperception that exists, you know, about Second Life, or they think that Second Life is just filled with teenagers and college students. And actually, I will guess that at least half of the Second Life residents now are probably over the age of 30. I know that Linden Labs probably isn't publicizing the demographical information, because I think that Linden Labs probably wants to have maybe a younger population coming into their virtual space. This game could potentially be expensive. A lot of people in the U.S. have said that a mesh head may cost us $10. Well, imagine if you're in a country where four of their local currency dollars is one U.S. dollar. They're spending $40 for a mesh head in Second Life. That's a lot of money. And, you know, there are items in Second Life that are even more than 10 U.S. dollars. So you can just imagine, for people who are outside of the U.S., this is an expensive virtual space to be part of. But I know that is a different topic than what I'm presenting as far as this article. But I just wanted to show this article to you to let you know that there are all types of people from all walks of life who find virtual spaces interesting and want to be part of them. And I'm sure that this is not the only billionaire who has found Second Life, who is finds online worlds interesting. So just consider that you don't know who's behind that avatar that you're meeting. And that's what makes this place interesting.